Following the recent live stream that went out, I believe there's a lot of confusion. Many people have seen the live stream, and unfortunately, because the people I was dealing with, they have decided to cause confusion and everything is convoluted, and the actual important issues are not being recognized by people. So I'm going to produce this to provide some clarity and to provide the context of what's going on here, inshallah ta'ala. So in summer 2023, I produced a video. The purpose of that video was to show everybody that sectarianism is very, very problematic. It's very damaging. There are a lot of things I said in that video, but in one portion of that video, I went through three problematic statements found in the books of Diyabandi elders, and also three problematic statements found in books that the Barelvis regard highly. And my point was, when you are of a sectarian mindset, you struggle to condemn things from your own group, and you find it very easy to condemn things from the other group. And that's not how the Muslim should be. And irrespective of who is saying something incorrect or making a terrible error or blunder, should stand with the haq, should stand with the truth. Now again, I do want to make it clear, I am not saying Abu Yazid al-Bistami said this, but what I'm saying is that's mentioned in the books. And it's mentioned in a book that's revered by this group, therefore it needs to be condemned. As you can see in that video, because it's still up, I didn't make takfir of anybody. That's not my teaching. That's not what I do. I'm opposed to making takfir of people. Rather, what I done in that video was simply say, both sides admit that these are errors, they are blunders, condemn them. That's all that needs to be done. All scholars will make mistakes. All movements will have scholars within them that make mistakes. And the correct thing to do, and something we as Sunni Muslims have never had an issue with in our history, is to simply point out, this is a great scholar, we like this scholar, he made a mistake. And this should be easy because, you know, these sectarian groups, they do this for each other. They point out faults in each other's books. It is closest to sincerity that you start with your own. So with books that you revere or you regard highly, start with those. So about a year later, Brother Hassan, he released a video refuting me, although he had nothing to do with the original video whatsoever. So he took my statement that it is attributed to Abu Yazid al-Bistami that he said, my flag will be bigger than the flag of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I had said that this should be condemned. So Brother Hassan released a video in refutation to that. To this day, I don't fully understand what he was refuting, because what he done in that video is quoted more from the book Tadhkiratul Awliya. And now, in our recent meeting, he said that that statement of Abu Yazid is kufr. So what was the purpose of his video other than to somehow try to defend that statement, which I will go into? But my point is, what was the purpose of a refutation video if you now agree with what I said is that statement is condemnable? And you go even further and you say the statement was kufr. So now, Brother Hassan and Brother Asrar are both saying that is a kufr statement, but that was not in his original video. In his original video, he provided an explanation, which I will call a justification. They further explained that the reason they're going into more detail than I did is so that, you know, there's no takfir made on Abu Yazid. I didn't make takfir on Abu Yazid in the first place. It makes no sense whatsoever. In the meeting, as you all saw, the brothers, all three of them, they said that Hassan was quoting from the book, because apparently I misquoted, even though what they're saying is exactly what I said. But in any case, they said Hassan was just quoting from the book. This is not the case. As I said, he was trying to defend this statement, which he's now calling kufr. And this is what happens when you, rather than accepting a mistake, a terrible mistake, when you try to cover it up, you get found out, and in a terrible manner. So let's see what happened. What he read in Urdu when he in his video was, Lekin dar haqiqat Khuda Taala ne aapki zaban se guftagu farmayi. He didn't translate this. Again, be careful, brothers, when you start accusing others of misquoting, you are often the most guilty. So he did not translate this. He provided his own explanation. The video's still there, everybody can see it. He said,
Se kalimat aapki zuban se nikle, لیکن در حقیقت خدا تعالی نے آپ کی زبان سے گفتگو فرمائی. He says that such a statement was said when Abu Yazid al-Bistami rahimahullah was in a spiritual state.
Such a statement was said when he, Abu Yazid, was in a spiritual state. That's not a translation of this. That is his own explanation. It is very clear he wasn't simply reading out what's in the book. He was providing an explanation. And if it had been the case, as Brother Asrar and Hassan are saying, that he was just quoting what is there, he wouldn't have said what he said. Rather, he would have said the following. Rather, in reality, God Most High spoke from his tongue or from his speech. That's what would have happened had he been simply quoting it. This is not a quote. He provided an explanation and thus a defense, and it came from him. So what Brother Hassan read was Allah Most High was speaking through his mouth, and he explained it as he was in a spiritual state. So he believes that people who are in a spiritual state, Allah Most High speaks through their mouth. This is his belief. So what does that mean? There's revelation after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The eternal attribute of speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resides within a shaykh. Are these his beliefs? There was no clarification in his video whatsoever. And in the meeting, every time I tried to speak about that, all three of them, and sometimes others as well, they would interrupt, because this is the critical point. And this is the point I focused on, because this is the most dangerous point in that video, saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was speaking through the mouth of another. Not only is it terrible for the reasons I've just stated, but it's also heavily praising an insult against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So now you're saying it's kufar, but what you read out is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was speaking through his mouth. How can it be kufr if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking through his mouth? It's so convoluted. And this is why I believe in the meeting, the brothers didn't want to have an actual discussion, because it's such a mess that they've created now. And this is why they just wanted to drive the conversation elsewhere. And I was trying my best to try to stick to the points. And this was the most important point. And I still call upon Brother Asrar and Brother Hassan to clarify this point. As for the fans and the followers of Brother Asrar, you can't simply say, oh, he's called it kufr, it's over now. Yes, good, he called the original statement kufr, but that wasn't the issue I focused on after Hassan's refutation. What I focused on is him quoting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was speaking through his mouth. All three brothers, they were saying, he's just quoting, yes, he quoted that Allah Most High speaks through was speaking through his mouth. Then he said from himself that this was a spiritual state. This is his explanation. No more hiding behind Fariduddin al-Attar. Now this becomes an aqidah issue. So what do you believe, Hassan and Brother Asrar? What are you teaching him? You teach aqidah. What are you teaching him? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks through the mouths of certain sheikhs? What is this belief? We have revelation after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have the eternal attribute of speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this person's mouth. These are the incredibly important aqidah points that had to be dealt with in the meeting. You caused confusion. The whole issue is so convoluted. They had to be dealt with. Rather, what happened? Straw men and going off on a tangent. This wasn't dealt with in the meeting. Deal with it now. In the meeting, the brothers kept speaking about misquoting is quite evident. I didn't misquote anything. They said the exact same thing that I said regarding Abu Yazid, but they themselves, ultimately, they were insisting on reading the full passage. They didn't read the full passage. The Urdu is on even my video. The Urdu is there. Anybody can pause it and try to read it. The story goes on. This entire episode, what happened in the meeting and prior to it, etc., this is a prime example of what I actually said in my original video, that sectarianism will take you to places that are terrible. Now, in the meeting that we had, there was a clear opportunity to just clarify everything. Look, we are speaking about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and how to deal with insults against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is an issue regarding, nobody should think about sect or group or sheikh. Everybody should side with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's why I was trying to focus on the meeting. in the meeting and I was calling the brothers too, but unfortunately it went all over the place. So I call upon the brothers who were in the meeting and everybody else. This is a very, very important issue. How do we deal with insults against the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do we make excuses? Do we provide convoluted, unclear answers, or we just say directly, this is unacceptable, nobody should defend it in any way, and certainly shouldn't take an insult against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and present it as praise.